I'm Cheryl Martin. I'm the acting director of ARPA-E, the Advanced Research Projects Agency for Energy. ARPA-E is focused on the development and the deployment of transformational energy technologies. Our funding is both catalytic and accelerative, where we fund across the energy landscape, everything from battery technologies for the grid or for the automobile, to carbon capture technologies, to advanced fuels. We partner with a wide variety of stakeholders, academics, industry, other government partners, from the beginning of our projects in order to accelerate the way that these ideas could potentially be embraced in the marketplace. ARPA-E truly challenges the whole idea of what is possible from both a technology as well as a model for how to do government funding. The ARPA-E Summit, I think, represents a lot of what ARPA-E is all about. It's about knowledge and networks. The summit brings together every awardee that ARPA-E is funding, as well as a number of other companies, small companies, large companies, who have innovative technologies, with corporate partners and other partners and sponsors. And in that time together over the 3 days, people learn about each other's innovations, and so those fortunate contacts that happen when people are in the same place focused on changing what's possible in energy. People form relationships that go on to be partnerships to move projects forward, potentially to fund projects in the future, or potentially a place where someone may want to acquire somebody else's technology to move something forward that they already have going on in the market. ARPA-E projects are three-year, $3 million projects. And so we ask the question all the time, what happens at the end of that 3 years? What happens at month 37? And so we focus significantly on handoffs. And there's a variety of types of ways that handoffs could happen for energy technologies. They may go on to another government partner for more advancement in a test bed with potentially the military or other parts of the Department of Energy. They may spin out into small companies, which are taking those groundbreaking ideas with entrepreneurs into the marketplace and going for further funding. We also have a significant amount of strategic partnerships, everything from MOUs to develop technology to outright acquisition of those technologies. This really is technology that could impact the global energy picture. And I think the combination of our innovation here with what is the constantly changing dynamic around the world of people's energy costs, policies, and own needs is going to provide, hopefully, a lot of places where these technologies could be deployed and find benefit for, you know, truly the world citizens.